So right now, because I am addressing the entire group of people. So right now, if I am telling this to everyone, eye contact is not required. Only the gaze is required. And again, there is a psychological reason behind it. I am talking, I am discussing it with all. There is no single person I want to pay attention to. It's for all. If I start maintaining an eye contact, let's say with Ankush, there will be thoughts coming into my mind, whether he's agreeing to what I'm saying or not. This will go on in the mind. Though I'll be telling that, okay, iceberg theory hai, ye hai, wo hai, but in the back of the mind, I will be, whether he's able to understand, isko pasand to aa raha hai na, aisa to nahi hai na, ki ye isko baad mein achha nahi lagega. N number of things I'll keep on thinking. If I maintain an eye contact while I'm addressing the mass, at that time only lighthouse gaze is required, like this, like lighthouse does. That's it. However, in case, let's say Atulji has asked a question, at that point of time when he's asking a question, it becomes the speaker's responsibility to provide 100% attention to that person who is asking the question and look at him with an eye contact and do the gestures that, yes, I'm able to understand or not understand, or would you please elaborate. Then when he gives the question to us, again, if the answer is only for him, I'll straight away look at him and give the answer. But if his question allows me to clarify the point for all the audiences, again the lighthouse gaze will start. And once that is done, I'll come back to Mr. Atul. Maybe I appreciate him. Thank you for asking this question. This has helped the entire room to clarify this.